Hi everyone, I am Jay Vishwanatham from Government Degree College Medak. So in this video that is about the topic is a circulatory system. So the circulatory system is very very important. Actually the main circulatory system is functioned by the blood. With the help of blood, the blood is very very important in the circulatory system, and the main structures also very important. In that structures, that is blood vessels and heart structure is very important. So actually, what is circulatory system? Actually, the circulatory system means transfer of blood and lymph to all cells and from one place to another place. That we are called as a circulatory. So transfer of blood or lymph from one place to another place means one organs to another organs, that we are called as a circulatory system. The circulatory system first discovered by William Harvey in 1628. So it's discovered in 1628. So what is the main function of the circulatory system? Actually, circulatory system transfer nutrients and oxygen to cells. So this is very important. It is transfer oxygen and nutrients. So it is transfer oxygen and nutrients. So this is very important. And the second one, the main function is carbon dioxide and excretory products are transferred from cells. So when the respiration is completed and when the digestion is completed, then the cells are produced carbon dioxide and that is unwanted food materials that we are called as a excretory products. So these excretory products and oxygens transferred from cells to their excretory organs means carbon dioxide is released into the lungs, and at the same time the excretory products are released into the are transferred to the excretory organs that we are called as the kidneys, right? So this is the main function of the circulatory system. And regulate body temperature. So means the blood regulate the body temperature as a equilibrium. So why, how it is maintained means it is contained in water, that is it contain blood volume, and it is transferred one organ to another organs as a circulatory. It is every time circulate in our blood vessels means arteries and veins. So our total body has a equilibrium temperature. That's why the circulatory system is very important for the regulate body temperature. And also circulatory system participate in the osmoregulation. So means osmoregulation means, so it is gain the water molecules, it gain observe the water molecules. So means the water is as a low concentrated material, means liquid status. So that low concentrated material is gained by blood as the process of osmoregulation. So means the circulatory system maintains the water volume in our blood. So this is very important functions of the circulatory system. One is transfer nutrients and oxygen to cells, and the second one is carbon dioxide and excretory products are transferred from the cells to their excretory organs, and third one is regulate body temperature, and fourth one is that is osmoregulation, means that is maintain the water volume in our body. So this is very important. So this is very important functions of the circulatory system. And actually circulatory system is main by the vessels. Actually blood vessels are present, but in the circulatory system there are two types of circulatory systems are there. One we are called as a open type of circulatory system. One we are called as a open type of circulatory system, and the second one we are called as a closed type of circulatory system. So this is closed type, and first one is open type of circulatory system. So what is open type of circulatory system? So blood vessels are absent. So in this type of circulatory system, the blood vessels are absent. In some animals, that the blood transferred from heart to cavity type structures called as sinuses. So this we are called as a sinuses. Actually, in our in some animals, the blood vessels are absent. But the if the blood vessels are absent, the blood transferred in the cavity like structures, that we are called as a sinuses, or we are also called as a coeloms, that we are also called as a coeloms. So that is coeloms are act as a sinuses. So in the coeloms, that is the transfer blood from sinuses to direct tissues. So means actually, suppose in human beings, heart is transfer the blood to all that is tissues with the help of blood vessels that we are called arteries. But here there is no arteries are present because blood vessels are absent. If absent, the blood is transferred through the sinuses or coelom to the all tissues, and again the tissues release the deoxygenated blood. That deoxygenated blood again transferred to the heart through the veins to heart. So means it's transfer the deoxygenated blood to the again heart, but heart is present in this type, but the blood vessels are absent, right? So this is called as a open type of circulatory system. Means the cavity like structures, as a not as a small blood vessels, there is a big size of cavities are present. That big size of cavities act for transfer of blood, that we are, it is a openly the blood is transferred as a, not as a sequentially, it is transferred as a randomly into the tissues. So that's why we are called as a open type of circulatory system. The best example for open type of circulatory system is arthropoda and mollusca. Arthropoda and molluscans. So means some invertebrates. So they don't have any blood vessels. The cavities are present. That cavities act for the transfer of blood. So in this blood, we are called as a hemolymph blood. Actually, in the blood vessels, the blood is transferred. That we are called blood. Blood vessels, the liquid is transferred. That we are called blood. But in this cavity, the blood is transferred. That blood we are called as a hemolymph, right? So that we are called as a hemolymph. So this is called hemolymph. The blood we are called as a hemolymph. That hemolymph transferred in cavities or coelom like structures. So this is open type of that is a circulatory system. So means example is arthropoda and molluscans. Molluscans are very important, and arthropods. Example is that is in the arthropod, cockroach is the best example, and Palaemon is also very best example for the that is open type of circulatory system. In the that is cockroach, it is a very best example because it contains the cavities in their body structure. That cavities act for the transfer of hemolymph. So this is about the open type of circulatory system. And second one, closed type of circulatory system. So the closed type of circulatory system means it is very closed means the in the blood vessels, very small size of blood vessels are transferred the blood. So means cavities are absent here. The particular blood vessels are present in the for the transfer of blood from heart to different tissues and organs, and again same after the transfer the oxygen, then deoxygenated blood is present. The deoxygenated blood again transferred to heart by the that is blood vessels that we are called veins. So the arteries and veins are present in their body there for the transfer of blood. So this is closed. The blood is transferred in the closed type tubes or blood vessels. So that's why we are called as a closed type of circulatory system. So blood vessels are present. So in the closed type, blood vessels are present, arteries and veins, that we are called arteries and veins. Blood transferred from heart to arteries to tissues and veins. Again, the veins transfer the blood to the heart. So it is a circular type of blood transfer is that, that is heart to arteries, arteries to tissues, and tissues to again veins. Veins are collected that blood and again transferred to heart. So this is called as a circulatory cycle or circulatory system, right? Mainly heart is the main key role for the transfer of or pumping the blood, and transfers arteries to the tissues, and again the deoxygenated blood is produced in the tissues and veins, and that veins are transferred the deoxygenated blood to the heart. So this is very, very important, right? This is very, very important for the transfer of blood. So this we are called as a closed type of circulatory system. The best example for closed type of circulatory systems are annelids. So these are also invertebrates, and cephalophores, halothurians. So these are all invertebrates, and all vertebrates are contain major closed type of circulatory system. They contain closed type of circulatory system. This is very, very important. Right, so this is about the what is a circulatory system, and what are the functions of circulatory system, and what is the types of circulatory systems are there in the circulatory system. But now that is main structure is there, that is heart structure is very important. Actually, this is a heart. So heart is present in the thorax, that we are called as a thorax region, or between the lungs. Actually, the thorax region between the lungs. So this is the main as a drawing image. So this is main. That is a heart structure like this. So this heart is present in the between the lungs. Actually, suppose these are the lungs. Between the lungs. That is beneath the lungs also, between the lungs, that is one cavity type of structure is present, as a box type of structure is present. This we are called as a mediastinum, so this is called mediastinum. So between the lungs, the box type structure is present. So this is a lung structure. The lungs are the lobes of the lungs are covered this mediastinum. In that mediastinum, the heart is present. In the mediastinum, the heart type of structure is present in the mediastinum. Right, this is the main point of the heart is present in the mediastinum between the lungs. Right. So actually, that is the weight of the lungs. Actually, the weight of the lungs has a 300 grams. Actually, the weight is only that is 300 grams every in person. Means the adult person, it is a 300 grams, and it is also covered by the heart is protected by. Suppose the heart is protected by ribs at the thoracic region, and a spinal cord at the dorsal side and ventral side thoracic, that is ribs are present, and it is also covered by lungs. Right, this is very important for the production of heart, because it is the main organ for the transfer of blood to the all tissues, the oxygenated blood, and collect the deoxygenated blood from the tissues. So this is heart structure. Actually, it is covered by layer. That layer we are called as a pericardium layer, right? Actually, suppose this is a heart. This heart is covered by one layer. That layer we are called as a pericardium layer. So in the pericardium layer, there are two layers are present. Suppose this is inner membrane of the pericardium layer, and This is outer membrane of the pericardium layer. So this is called external membrane of the pericardium layer. The red color is inner membrane of the pericardium membrane, right? So between the pericardial membranes, the cavity is present, that we are called as a pericardial space or cavity is present. Pericardial membrane space or cavity is present. So this cavity is filled with that is coelom like structure. This cavity is filled with the coelom as a means, as a blood, as a liquid like structure. This is very important in the heart structure because it is protect from the shocks or some some highly movements, and when they are jumped and when they are high in that stage and some in the accidents, the heart is protected by the pericardial membrane. Pericardial membrane is very important. So it contains the fluid like structure between the two pericardial and outer and inner pericardial membrane. The fluid like structure is act as a suspension for the heart, because it protects the heart walls and heart blood vessels and chambers from the different highly dangerous actions. So this is very important. So this pericardial membrane, so the heart is covered by membrane that we are called a pericardial membrane, that we are called as a pericardial membrane. Pericardial membrane. So this is very important. So the pericardial membrane, right? And again, every heart valve. So actually, we are discussed on the outer membranes of the protected membrane, pericardial membrane. But in the suppose we are dissect here. Suppose this is the heart wall. We are observing the microscope. In the heart wall, there is the three layers are present. The outer layer, outer side of the wall, that we are called epicardium, and inner we are called as a that is mesocardium, and inner membrane, middle membrane we are called as a mesocardium, and inner membrane we are called as a endocardium. Third one we are called as a endocardium. So there are three membranes are present in the wall of the heart, not outside of the membrane. In the wall of the heart, there are three membranes are present, that we are called epicardium, myocardium. Second one we are called myocardium, and third one we are called inner membrane, we are called as a endocardium. So this is outer membrane. Suppose this is inner membrane. In the wall of the heart, this is a middle membrane and this is inner membrane. Epicardium, myocardium and endocardium. So it is the structure of the heart wall, right? These are the three members. Membranes are very important for the protect of the heart wall also. So this is about the membrane of the heart wall. And in the structure, when the structure deeply we are observed the heart structure, actually in the heart there are four chambers are present. So four chambered heart is present in all animals, meaning mainly in the vertebrates. But in the fishes, suppose in the fishes only two chambers are present, one arterium and one ventricle. One auricle and one ventricle is present in the fishes. So this is very important. In the amphibians, the four is present, but mainly ventricles are not well developed as a two chambers. That's why only three chambers are present in the heart. Two auricles and one ventricle. Reptiles, suppose it is a three chamber is in the amphibians. Externally we are seen as a four, but internally the three chambers are present in the amphibians, but in the reptiles, the reptiles contain four chambers actually. The reptiles also contain four chambers, but the complete chambers are not formed in the reptiles. But in the reptiles, we are observing the crocodile structure, crocodile heart structure. In the crocodile is also belongs to reptiles, but in their heart structure, the complete four chamber heart is present in the crocodile heart structure. But remaining reptiles, it is not a complete heart. We are called as a incomplete heart is present. Heart structure is present in the reptiles. So that is very important. And in the that is aves. So in the aves, the complete heart structures are present in the aves and mammals. Both are shows complete structure of hearts, means there are complete four chambers are present in the heart structure. If from the four chambers, we are called two from auricles and two from that is from chamber, two is ventricles. So two auricles and two ventricles. So these are very important. Two auricles and two ventricles are very important. Suppose justly observe here in the image. So this one, one, this is two, this is three, and this is four. So these are the four chambers in heart structure. One, two, we are called as a auricles. So auricles, if it is present at the right side, that we are called right atrium or auricle. Two is present at the left side, that we are called left atrium or auricles. And beneath the auricles, so the be under the auricles that is next to under chambers, that we are called third is we are called as a right ventricle, and fourth we are called as a left ventricle, right? So means the four chambers are completely divided, are completely present. The first and second atriums, means the left and right atriums, are divided by the that is septum. So it is divided by the septum. That septum we are called as a auricular septum. So here, so this is we are called, this is auricular septum. So intra-auricular septum, the two are divided by auricular septum, and the two ventricles also divided by ventricular septums. This is ventricular septum and this is auricular septums. And that 1, 2, and 3, 4 means auriculum, auricles and or atriums and ventricles are divided by that is completely by the one that is one layer septum, that we are called as a auricular ventricular septum. So that is very important. So this is called auricular ventricular septum. That is, auricular septum is divided right and left side of the atriums. Ventricular septum is divided that is right ventricular and left ventricular, but the auricles and ventricles are divided by this type of membrane septum, that we are called auricular ventricular septums. So these are the four chambers are separated by septums. There are three types of septums. One we are called auricular septum, ventricular septum, and auricular ventricular septums. And the the right auriculum, the right atrium. The right atrium means this first one. The right atrium gain the deoxygenated blood from the inferior vein and superior vein, vena cavas. That we are called superior vena cava and inferior vena cavas. Superior vena cavas are two are collected the blood, deoxygenated blood from the head and thoracic region. And this inferior vein, vena cava, is collected the deoxygenated blood from the posterior of the animals. So the deoxygenated blood collected and released into the or transported into the that is right auriculum or right atrium. So this is very important. But in the two chamber, second chamber, that we are called as a left atrium. So the left atrium collect the blood from the that is lungs. That lungs transfer the blood, that we are called oxygenated blood. So this is oxygenated blood is present. So this septums are removed. Right. So in the left auriculum, that is oxygenated blood is present. Here oxygenated blood, here deoxygenated blood is transferred. Right. The deoxygenated blood is transferred from the that is total over the body with the help of inferior vena cava and from the superior vena cava. But in the left atrium or auricle, the oxygenated blood transferred from the pulmonary vein, which is collected the blood from the lungs, that we are called pulmonary vein. The pulmonary vein collected the and transfer that into the left atrium. So this is very important. Actually, veins are transferred deoxygenated blood. Actually, veins are transferred deoxygenated blood into the that is heart. But here, that is different. The pulmonary vein is a vein. Actually, it is transferred the oxygenated blood into the left atrium. That is the very important point. Remember about the veins. Actually, all veins are transferred deoxygenated blood into the heart. That is right atrium. But one vein is there, that is the pulmonary vein, transferred oxygen blood into the left atrium. So this is very important. And that is arteries. Actually, arteries collect the oxygenated blood. Arteries are collected the oxygenated blood from the heart. The veins are transferred the blood into the heart, but the arteries are transferred the blood to the cells from heart. Veins collected the blood from organs to heart, transfer the heart, but arteries transfer the oxygenated blood from the heart to organs. So this is reverse process between the arteries and veins. Veins are collected to transfer heart, but arteries collect heart to organs. So means the heart is pumping and collecting between the organs. The heart collecting the blood and pumping the blood between the organs. So the arteries, suppose arteries, discuss about the arteries. So in the arteries structure, actually arteries are collected that is oxygenated blood. So this is aorta. So the main arteries, this we are called as a main aorta. This main aorta collected the oxygenated blood from left ventricle. This is very important. Means main aorta is containing that is collected that is oxygenated blood and transferred to organs. Right, so this is very important. But another aorta is there that we are called this one. So actually it is collected deoxygenated blood from the ventricle. So how the deoxygenated blood present in the right ventricle, means the first atrium and auricle transfer the that is deoxygenated blood into the right ventricle. At the same time, the left atrium oxygenated blood transferred into the left ventricle. The left ventricle is transferred oxygenated blood to the aorta, and right ventricle transferred deoxygenated blood into the pulmonary aorta. Right, pulmonary aorta. So this pulmonary aorta is collected deoxygenated blood and transferred the lungs. But the main aorta is collected the oxygenated blood and transferred to all organs. So actually aortas or arteries are transferred oxygenated blood only. But here this is different. The deoxygenated blood transferred to lungs with the help of pulmonary artery or artery, pulmonary artery. So this is the main point, main remember point about the that is arteries. And already we had discussed main point about the veins, that is the pulmonary vein collecting oxygenated blood. Here pulmonary artery collected deoxygenated blood from right ventricle and transferred to lungs. So this is very important. It is very important to remember question about the veins and aorta. And also that is right. So this inferior vena cava and superior vena cavas are transferred the that is deoxygenated blood into the right atrium with the help of one four like structure, wall like structure is there, that we are called as a that is Eustachian valve. The Eustachian valve is formed by the opening of inferior vena cava. Sorry, that is we are called as a so the inferior vena cava is transfer the blood into the that is right atrium by the opening. That opening we are called as a Eustachian opening, Eustachian valve. So Eustachian valve. But the superior vena cavas are opened by the wall, that we are called Tibiasis valve. Suppose they are also open into this here, that we are called Tibiasis valve. That we are called as a Tibiasis valve. So means the inferior vena cava is open into the that is right atrium, that we are called Eustachian valve, and the super vena cavas are open into the right atrium also, that we are called as a Tibiasis valves. So these valves are very important for the flow of blood into the right atrium. Again, it is not that the after flowing of the blood remain not enter into the super vena cava and inferior vena cava by the with the help of Eustachian and Tibiasis valves. So these are present here. Suppose this is Tibiasis of the, so actually the Tibiasis is open here, the superior vena cavas are open here. So this is called Tibiasis, this is called Eustachian valve. So this is Eustachian, this is Tibiasis. Sorry, this is Eustachian and this is Tibiasis. So these are the main that is structure of the heart. Again, so in the structure of the heart, that is in the at the time of embryonic stage, between the auricles, one small size of pore is present. Between the auricles, one small size of pore is present. As a opening is present, it is connected between right atrium and the left atrium, that we are called as a fossa ovale. That we are called as a fossa ovale or foramen ovale. Actually we are called as a foramen ovale. So means in the embryonic stage, means at the time of development in the uterus of the mother, at the time of development of the heart, these two chambers are connected by the opening. That opening we are called as a foramen ovale. After when his birth and he is going to, after the birth, it is going to close, that we are called as fossa ovalis. Fossa ovalis, foramen ovale is the opening part between the right and the left atriums. But after birth, it is closed by the going of development, it is going to close it. That we are called fossa ovalis. Foramen ovale and fossa ovalis. So this is the closing opening of the between the two atriums. Foramen ovale and fossa ovalis are the very important in the embryonic stage. Foramen ovale is opening part between the auricles atriums or auricles. after development is completed, it is remaining as a one, it is closed and remaining as a one structure that we are called fossa ovalis. So this is about heart structure. And that is actually when we are observed as externally heart, the two chambers are completely, the right auricle and left auricles are completely divided by one septum. Actually internally they are divided by the that is auricular septum, but externally we are also observe on the that is auricles, one septa is external septa is present, it is completely divided the two auricles, and also it is divided the ventricles. Suppose it is also divided completely ventricles. So means auricles or ventricles are completely deeply divided by the external septum, that we are called as a coronary sulcus. That we are called as a coronary sulcus. Coronary sulcus. The dividing of the externally auricles or ventricles by the one septum as a deep septum, that we are called coronary sulcus. So that is called coronary sulcus, right? And also this is the deep septum is present between the auricles and ventricles. Clearly visible that the two are separated by this coronary sulcus, and also that is the auricles are covered the ventricles as a 25% of the anteriors of the ventricles. Suppose these auricles they extend their structure on the that is ventricles. The auricles are extend their posterior structure on the ventricles. When this we are removed, the coronary sulcus is clearly observed. So this extended structures we are called as a auricular appendix, that we are called as a auricular appendix. So auricular appendix means the auriculums are extended their structure on the anterior part of the ventricles, the anterior part of the ventricles. So these are the very important structure in the that is externally by the auricles. So this is also very important for the remember. And now, so in the structure of right atrium, the point is present, this point, this we are called as a SA node, that is sinus auricular node. Means this is the face marker of the heart, means it produce the that is contractiles and relaxations, means signals are produced for the heart contractile and relaxation by the one node, that we are called as a SA node. The SA node is very important structure that is present near the that is right atrium, right? So it is also extend their that is muscles are extend their myonemes into the another node, that we are called AV node, that is auricular ventricular node near the ventricular region, auricular and ventricular region. That means that is auricular ventricular septum, near the auricular ventricular septum again one node is present, that node we are called as a AV node. So this is SA node and this is AV node. This both are very important. These are produced the signals for the contractile and relaxation signals to the total heart structure by the with the help of AV nodes. So this AV node again produced structures that is my that is fiber like structures that we are called as a, this is suppose these are the structures total ventricles. So this we are called as a Purkinje fibers, right? So these are called as a Purkinje fibers. The Purkinje fibers are extended into the wall of the ventricles, and these are caused to contractile and relax, expanding contractile and relaxation of the heart structure. by the with the help of SC node and AV node, right? So near the AV node there is a bundle of number of fibers are produced. This we are called as a bundle of His. The scientist name that is we are called as a bundle of His. The scientist name is His. So based on that, the name called as a bundle of His. So here the number of bundle is produced into the whole total hot structure. This we are called bundle of His. So it is also produced from the AV node, right? So SA node is present in the right atrium. It is extended their structure myofibers and into the AV node, which is present at the auricular ventricular septum, and that AV node again produce the fibers that we are called Purkinje fibers, and these Purkinje fibers are connected with bundle of His, that is the number of myofibers are present. So this is about the structure, and also between the auricles and between the ventricles, this structure, tricapsid walls are present and mitral or bicapsid walls are present. So means the oxygenated blood transferred into the left to right ventricle by the walls are present. That walls we are called mitral walls. And at the same time, the deoxygenated blood is transferred into the right ventricle from the right atrium by the three walls that we are called tricapsid walls. So here the only two is present, that we are called bicapsid. Here three walls are present, that we are called tricapsid. That bicapsid we are also called as a mitral wall. These are the mitral walls, these are the tricapsid walls. So means the auricles or ventricles are connected by the opening. That opening we are called as a auricular and ventricular opening. If it is present, that opening is present at the right structures, means right atrium, right ventriculum, that we are called right atrium ventricle opening. If it is present at the left side, that we are called left atrium ventricle opening. So this we are called openings. Between the auricles and ventricles, this we are called openings. Near these openings, the tricapsid is present and bicapsid is present. These are control the flow of the blood by the discontinuously release the with the help of, and they are functioned based on the contractile and relaxation of the heart structure. So this is the tricapsid and bicapsid or mitral walls of the heart structure. And also again the main aorta and pulmonary aorta are produced. This is main aorta. So this is main aorta and this is pulmonary aorta. So which is transfer the deoxygenated blood to the lungs. So actually deoxygenated blood transferred through the lungs that we are called pulmonary aorta. So this pulmonary aorta is produced from the right side ventricle. It is opening in by the right side ventricle, and at the same time the main aorta is open in the left ventricle to the outside. So means the pulmonary aorta is open into by through the right ventricle, and main aorta is open into the open. It is open outside by the left ventricle. So means this main aorta is transport oxygenated blood to the organs. This pulmonary aorta is transport the deoxygenated blood to the lungs, which are present near the heart. This is transport that deoxygenated blood. Where the distantly present organs, that organs gain by the oxygenated blood by the main aorta, right? And also you observe the structure of the ventricle. Suppose structure of the ventricle, this foldeds. Actually there is a foldeds are we are seeing. This we are called as a cardia tendineae, sorry, columnae carniae. That we are called as a columnae carniae. So in the structure of the that is ventricles, so these are the structure we are called as a columnae corneae. So means these are the very important for the extend the ventricles. Actually this is the relaxant stage. If the blood volume is increased in the ventricle at right and left side, the heart structure will be elongated, means slightly it is expanded with the help of this columnae corneae. This is very important. And again, one thing is that the walls of the heart that we are called that is tricapsid walls and mitral walls, that is they are functioned by fiber-like structure that we are called cardia tendinae. Cardia tendinae. That's cardia tendons operate the opening and close of the walls. And also in the pulmonary and in the main aorta, pulmonary aorta and main aorta, there is a again walls are present. That walls we are called as a. So here and here the walls are present. That walls we are called as a. That is semilunar walls. So here, semilunar. Semilunar walls. So that is the pulmonary aorta and the main aorta is opening by the semilunar walls into the right ventricle and left ventricle. So this is the structure of heart. There are four chambers and ventricles. That is the Eustachian valve and the Basius valve and about the SA node and about the AV node and hence that is bundle of His and also that is the septums are present. What is a columnae carnae and what is a cardiac tendinae and again what is that is pulmonary vein and what is the main important of that is what we are called artery. Lung that is main aorta that is pulmonary aorta and so here one is okay. So this is about the what is tricapsid and what is mitral walls and what is semilunar walls and what is columnae carnae, right? What is coronary sulcus? So these are very important in the heart structure. Thank you.